I'm Riddhi Walia and I'm from Delhi, India. So I've recently qualified as a CPA. I started my first job with EY, Ernst & Young, as an audit associate. Currently, I'm working with Halliburton. That's in Bangalore. It's a US-based company. Actually, usually, you know, whenever you think of a CPA, it's generally that people tell you financial accounting and reporting is the toughest. And to the contrary, I just felt, you know, I was better with FAR. And I think BEC, people say it's the easiest. And I think I've struggled with BEC the most. I felt that, you know, because, you know, usually when you study regulation, FAR, or, you know, be it audit. So with every chapter, there is a, I think, link. You study one chapter, then, you know, somewhere one, the previous chapter makes a, you know, foundation for the other chapter, which I feel. But when I was studying for BEC, I think I just lost track. I thought one time I'm like studying variances and the other moment I'm studying like economics. So it kind of, you know, it really bothered me at that time. So for me, I would say BEC and a little bit of regulation because of the mugging up, you know, all the laws and all the new provisions. And I think that was a little tough for me, but I made few sheets. You know, people usually call them cheat sheets, or, you know, I think they call them some flashcards. I think people prepare that, you know. So I made a sheet and I made sure that, you know, every day if I sit before for my regulation paper, each day I used to go through those sheets again and again before starting my day's target. It was necessary because, you know, there are set of limitations that you have to remember, because ultimately you'll forget in the exam, and, you know, you can't rely on the exam that they'll give you the limitations. So you have to be really prepared on that part. So I made sure that I, you know, go through that sheet again and again, like till the last day. So that's how my journey was with these four parts. Order in which I gave my exam was I gave financial accounting reporting first, because I wanted to set a foundation for my accountancy, because, you know, if you know that, maybe probably that's going to help you in the other parts, what I felt. So I started with FAR and I scored an 82. I scored an 82 in FAR. And then I was really bad at auditing, because it's a lot of theory. There is nothing, you know, that you can solve or anything. It's because I think the trickiest paper, if you ask me, is audit. I think because, you know, there are such close answers. Like in the four options, you would usually, you know, you would know it, that there are two options that are completely not the answers. But there are two options which, you know, which are so, like, they resemble each other so much. There is just one word difference and you have to choose the most appropriate. Like, both can apply, but then the most appropriate answer. So I think that took a toll on me at that moment. So I think I scored the least in out of the four exams in audit. That was a 76. I just passed. So I think audit was a nightmare when I saw my result, but I was happy that, you know, I don't have to give it again. So yeah. And then I gave BEC, because people used to say that BEC is easy. So I thought that, you know, let me get done with one easier subject. But then it was not easy for me personally. But then it can be easy for the other person. So I think I scored in BEC 80. So yeah. And then my last examination was in Corona, COVID situation. So in regulation, I scored an 87. Actually, before that, I was going to UAE to give my exams, Middle East, because that's the closest to India, the centers. Earlier, we didn't have exams in India. So we were, Indian students were allowed to go to US or to Middle East to, you know, sit for their examinations. So for my first three paper, I went to Abu Dhabi. But since then COVID happened, we were told that, you know, papers have been delayed. So then fortunately, I was just praying, you know, I wanted to get done with this, because I was waiting to get done. It was my last exam. So fortunately, what happened, I think Brometric centers, you know, decided that why not for, because Indian students were, there were a lot of Indian students who were struggling. So for, specifically for Indian students, what they decided was that, you know, they'll open centers in their cities. So I got a chance to, you know, sit for my last exam in my own city. So that was a very good opportunity. And that's how, you know, otherwise I would have been in a miserable situation where, like, you know, one exam left and doing nothing at all. So, you know, I just got, I was just lucky.